If you shoot bracketed images and you use ON1 Photo RAW, then you really need to know how to use stacks. Today, we're gonna dive into how you can use stacks inside of ON1 Photo RAW to make your images more organized and a little bit easier for you to get those brackets. Let's go. So here we are inside of the computer and inside of ON1 Photo RAW, and you can see I have a series of 168 images that I need to get organized. Now, here's the deal. I showed how to use the auto stacking feature in the past. Today, I'm going to show you a more intentional approach, and this is specifically for people who are using bracketed shots. And if you're not familiar with what I mean by bracketed, that means you're taking 3, 5, 9 exposures, essentially all in one series or in one go, or within, you know, let's say a minute of themselves, depending on how you got your shutter speed set up. But the point here is we're going to use ON1 to find all of those images and then stack them. And that's going to make it so much easier. So what we're going to do is come up to our menu bar here, and we're going to click on photo. And this is no different than what we've been doing. And you do have to have ON1 Photo RAW 2025 for this to work. We're going to come down to the very bottom here where it says stacks. At the very bottom here, you can see we have automatic stacking, and that's what we're going to use. We're going to go ahead and click that, and then ON1 is going to try to start stacking these images on their own. Now, you can see I have my settings already set from a previous shoot when I did this exact same technique. But if you shoot bracketed, what I'm going to recommend you do is you move the visual similarity all the way down to 0. That's essentially turning it off, so that way ON1 doesn't even consider the visual similarity as a factor to stack your images. I find that this is very helpful, especially when I have a folder where not everything is a bracket or a series of images that were bracketed, and you can see that in the example folder here. But if I turn it off, all it's going to do is use the time between each stack. Now, for me, I knew that anywhere from 3 to 5 seconds would probably work well for most of the brackets that I photograph. So all I did was I pulled the time between stacks down to 5. All right. And this is where I leave my automatic stacking, because most of the time for me, I'm shooting bracketed images and I want to stack all of the like images together. So what I do is I look in the background to see if it's actually giving me the result that I want. So here's a series of 3 images. I have a series of 1, 2, and 3, and those ones are grouped together nicely. And then I know that I didn't start shooting my bracketed images until I got to this particular display. And then I went ahead and said, you know what, I should probably shoot these in brackets. So I'm looking here and I'm seeing that the first set of images that I bracketed, ON1 picked up on based off of that 5-second timer or interval. And then if I keep going down here, I can see that. Now, what I would love for ON1 to do is allow us to scroll through so we can actually verify that this is doing what we want it to do in the background. The preview that I have here, it's good, but it's not always the best representation because, you know, it's just one of those things. I would love to be able to scroll through a little bit further to see how well ON1 really is stacking these. But beyond that, I can look at the images that I shot outside of the National Archives, and those were not bracketed images, by the way. Those were just images that were shot really close together, and they seem ON1 was like, hey, the timing matches. I'm going to go ahead and stack these. And I'm not mad at that. I can live with it. But once I'm done, I'm going to go ahead and hit stack. Now, I want to note, I only had 168 images in this folder, which is relatively light when we start talking about bracketed images. And so for ON1 to create those stacks, you've seen that it created somewhere roughly around 30 stacks. that is really, really easy work for ON1 to go through. Now, if you are photographing with thousands of images, it is going to take a lot longer than what I'm demonstrating here. So I want to make sure that I set expectations appropriately. For those of you who are hoping ON1 is going to move faster when you have a lot of images, it's not. It's going to take some time. So I would recommend doing this probably before your culling or after your culling session, however you want. I would do this before culling and then come back and take a look. So let's go ahead and jump back into the computer and see how well ON1 really did with getting all of these items together. So here we are back inside of the computer, and you can see I actually have a pretty good set here. I'm down to 54 images being displayed, and I want to explain this for a second. So ON1 is not getting rid of any of my images. Again, it's just stacking them. And this number down here represents the number of previews that are showing up in the folder that you have selected. All right. It's not saying that you have 54 images. It's just saying that there's 54 previews that are showing up inside of this folder. Now, if I were to, let's see, if I click here and I expand that, you can see it's now showing an additional preview. And then this number changes down here at the bottom to 55. So you got to be careful with stacks, all right? And I'm mentioning this because I made this mistake. I stacked a series of images and thought that I had lost a good portion of them. But in fact, they were actually roped into a stack because of the timing. All right. So this method is not perfect. This method is really good. I enjoy this method. I use this method in my personal work, which is what I'm showing you right here. This is all my personal work that I shot today. I can only attest to that much about this technique. You definitely have to figure out how to use the tool for yourself as you are working inside of ON1, but this is the way that I've found ON1, or at least the auto stacking feature, to be helpful for me. The similarity thing, it's nice if I'm not shooting brackets, but that's for a different video. I'll show you how I use that when I'm not shooting bracketed images or looking to stack bracketed images. But if I'm being honest, the time is what I use the most in my own work, because usually when I'm photographing, and I don't know about you, you may be photographing something and then there could be 10 seconds, give or take. And if there's 10 seconds in between each shot, then you just set up your timing to be 10 seconds. And look at that. You now have all your images going into stacks. And, you know, so anything that's less than 10 seconds, it's going to say, no, that needs to be in a stack, and so forth and so on. All right. You got to play around with the tool. That's where I'll leave that. But let's go ahead and scroll through here and take a look. So I'm going to collapse this one. And then you can see it brought me back to 54. But if I scroll through here, let me see. This one has 6 images inside of it. All right. And those 6 images are probably really close to each other, because all I did was change the framing just a little bit in the second shot. It's really 2 bracketed series, but I changed the framing a little bit. You can see I left a little bit more space on the back end of the image as opposed to this one where I was a little bit tighter. All right. So we'll go ahead and collapse that again, and we'll come down here near the bottom, because I shot a series of images that I'm also going to turn to a panorama. And you can see I have 18 images in this stack. All right. Now, when you're out in the field and you're photographing, you kind of got to think through, at least I think through, how I'm going to work with these images when I get back to my computer. And especially, how am I going to organize these images when I get back to my computer? Because for me, I need to be able to find my images, and organization is so important. But you can see I have a series of images all in this one stack. So it's a lot easier for me to go and find these images later down the line when I'm ready to start working with them. And I know that I have everything I need in one area. All right. That's how I am using the auto stacking tool inside of ON1 Photo RAW when I shoot bracketed images. Now, again, I will make a separate video when I'm just photographing single images and I want to stack those and use the visual similarity, but I do use the timing more so than the visual similarity. I recommend, you know, like I'll just let the cat out of the bag. Only move the visual similarity up to one and don't go past two. Anything beyond that, I find that ON1 does not do the best job at identifying, at least for my photography, all right? Maybe your photography will be a little bit different, but for me, I find that ON1, it does really good at one, it does okay at two, and then three and beyond, it just doesn't do any good for me. So if you found value in the content, go ahead and smash the like button. If you got questions, leave them in the comment section below. I'd love to help out and answer any questions that you have. If you want to learn more about using ON1 Photo RAW, consider signing up for a coaching call with me. You can do so at the link down in the description box below. It'll take you over to my website so you can sign up for a coaching call with me. Now, if you want to save a little bit of money when you shop over at the ON1 store, consider using my coupon code FreeWillPhotos20. I do make a small commission every time someone uses it, but it's at no extra cost to you, and I greatly appreciate it. It helps continue funding this channel so I can keep making the content that you all love and enjoy. If you got questions, leave them down in the comment section, and until the next time, I want you to stay inspired and keep creating. Peace.